shows. He played big in the second half. There is 1 minute remaining in the contest. Lawrence has settled down. Now they're going to have to start looking for a shot. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Swan says, let's go to work. Fourth. Sessoms. His first game. A three-pointer and a possible four-point play.
What a shot. Look at his teammates. This game is not won yet. So you got to remain cool, but they just cannot contain their excitement and pleasure over that three-pointer.
Petey Sessoms, who hadn't hit a basket all night long. He was 0-for-6 from the floor. He drills the three-pointer and the foul. This could be a four-point play.
Well, both coaches going to their strength. Here's Petey Sessoms, the three. Got fouled. And look at this excitement. I've never seen anything like this.
Foul is on Cornell Parker. That's his fourth.
ODU leads by four.
Four-point play for Petey Sessoms. ODU leads 71-66, 42 seconds left. Cornell Parker off the mark, but he was fouled.
In the three-point zone, so I believe that's a three free throws.
Yes, it is.
You don't want to foul Parker not shooting a three. If you're going to foul him, foul him before he gets his arms up in the act of shooting. Mistake there by Mike Jones, the only mistake he's made in this game.
That's his fourth foul. Kevin Swan is back in. Replacing Harvey. 35 seconds left. ODU leads by five. And Cornell Parker, the masked man, will shoot three free throws.
...63% free throw shooter. And he short-armed that when the fans are really giving it to him.
Oh, boy.
Going for the hat trick.
Petey Sessoms had a nightmarish evening stepping forward and getting a four-point play that may have iced it. Parker salvages one free throw, and it's 71-67 ODU. Full court pressure by Virginia. They need the ball. Down by four with 13 seconds to go, and Dean in a very rough foul, pushing Swan down. And Swan will shoot two.
This is a good basketball team. 2 years ago, Oliver Purnell took his team to the NCAA tournament. Last year, the NIT. This team's better than any one of those two teams. It is clear-cut the favorite in the CAA.
One, two, four, three at the free throw line tonight. David Harvey is back in for the Monarchs. They lead 74-69, 12 seconds to go. That's a Junior Burroughs performance, 29 points. He also has 13 rebounds. That matches his career high. Havlicek for three. Rebounded by Larkin. And he is fouled with 2 seconds to go, and the ODU fans begin to celebrate. Big win for the Monarchs.
This is a huge win for Oliver Purnell and his ball club. And the way they did it, too, without Petey Sessoms coming on until the end when he makes that four-point play, how they hung in there against a tough, nasty Virginia ball club on that defense. I'll tell you, they are impressive when they play the D. They're just going to have to find a way to score some baskets.
Kevin Larkin, 2-for-2 at the free throw line tonight. Well, when you can win with your leading scorer having an off night, and we're not hitting the three-point shots, two big parts of their arsenal, pretty impressive.
That is impressive.
Odell Hodge with 23 points leading the offense for the Monarchs.
Says something about their depth, too. Jones coming in the second half, giving them a big lift in when Sessoms was not hitting. Larkin playing a great floor game.
That'll do it.
And the fans, they're coming out on the floor. Look out, Bill.
You would think they have just won the NCAA tournament, but they've won the championship in the state of Virginia anyway.
This is a huge win for Old Dominion. Check this celebration out.
Well, the Monarchs are off to one of their best starts in history now. 5-0. Virginia drops to 3-2. Our player of the game tonight, ODU center Odell Hodge, who had 23 points and 9 rebounds. Final score tonight from Norfolk, ODU 76, Virginia 69.